pyrocinetrate is equal to 1 only. And Q of pyrocinetrate is equal to 1 only. Now, one more function also we have to discuss. The corresponding function is similarly, in this case, we have considered integration of pyrocinetrate to infinity. Fx of x dx is equal to 1. Now, I am taking integration 0 to infinity. Integration 0 to infinity, fx of dx equal to, what will be the value? Integration 0 to infinity, e to the power minus x square by 2 dx with 1 by root 2 pi equal to, what is this value? This is equal to 1 by 2, is equal to 1 by 2. Since 1 by root 2 pi, integration minus infinity to infinity, 1 by root 2 pi, integration minus infinity to infinity is equal to 1, and 1 by root 2 pi, 0 to infinity, e to the power minus x square by 2 dx is equal to 1 by 2. From this part, we conclude one more function. By taking the substitution or by doing a small simple modification, I'm taking this x square by 2 equal to p square. I'm taking this x square by 2 equal to p square. Nothing is there as we have discussed earlier. Okay, the substitution x square by 2 is equal to p square. Then 2x dx, 2x dx by 2 is equal to 2p dp. By 2 equal to 2p dp, 2 will get cancelled. And dx is equal to 2p divided by x dp, 2p by x dp. And what is the value of this x? X is equal to root 2p only. X is equal to root 2p only. This is equal to root 2p dp. And this value is equal to root 2 dp. Listen carefully. This value is equal to root 2 dp dx equal to. By doing this one, by substituting here, what you will get? This value equal to 1 by root 2 pi as it is. 1 by root 2 pi as it is, and dx is equal to root 2 dp, I am placing this root 2 equal to here, and the limits are no problem. So because 0 and infinity, the limits are no problem. 0 to infinity, e to the power minus p square dp is equal to 1 by 2, e to the power minus p square dp is equal to 1 by 2. From this, how can you write root 2 root 2 will get cancelled, and this is equal to 2 by root pi. I am taking this 2 as in this side. Okay, no problem. 1 by root 2, 1 by root pi, integration 0 to infinity, e to the power minus p square dp is equal to 1 by 2. From this, we are writing 2 by root pi, integration 0 to infinity, e to the power minus, nothing is there. Okay, don't be confused and don't be getting any doubt. Okay, nothing is a simple integration. Integration and substitution. Okay, nothing. Okay, 2 by root pi, 0 to infinity, e to the power minus p square dp, minus p square dp, and this I can be writing as the 2 by root pi integration 0 to k e to the power minus p square dp minus t square dp plus 2 by root pi integration k to infinity e to the power minus p square dp is equal to 1 minus p square dp is equal to 1, and they are calling this one as a complementary error function ERFC of k, and this corresponding as the ERF of k. Finally, we have ERFC of k is equal to complementary error function. ERFC of k is equal to 2 by root pi integration k to infinity e to the power minus x square dx, this I can call. Okay, minus p square dp can be called as the e to the power minus x square dx. And what about this ERF of k? ERF of k is equal to 2 by root pi integration 0 to k e to the power minus x square dx. And we can say this ERF of k plus ERF of minus k is equal to 1 always. ERF of k plus ERFC. Complementary error function of this k. Sorry. ERF of k plus ERFC of k is equal to 1 always. Now, as we have seen earlier, Q of minus k plus Q of k is equal to 1. And where Q of k equal to limits are from k to infinity. And Q of minus k are the limits are from minus infinity to k. But here, we are having complementary error function. The limits are from k to infinity. And here, the corresponding limits are from the corresponding limits are from 0 to k. All these expressions are very, very important. And you have to be remember, you have to get a good analyzation in the mind, directly you can get the corresponding expression for the complement error function. If you are not having the analyzation, you have to be remember, don't be remember, you should have the analyzation. Okay, if you have the analyzation, corresponding equal to 2 by root pi, k to infinity e power minus x square dx. If you do two times of this analyzation, you may not forget, even if you want to forget. Okay, you may not forget, even if you want to forget the expression for the complement error function x and the q of it and the q of k. Now write down by taking this complementary error function ER of C of K is equal to 1 by root 2 by root 2 pi. ER of C of K is equal to 2 by root pi e to the power minus x square dx from limits are from k to infinity. 2 by root pi k to infinity. Now I am placing here this x square is equal to p square by 2. X square is equal to p square by 2. Placing this x square is equal to p square by 2. Are doing this value equal to 2x dx is equal to p dp and dx is equal to p by 2x. X value is equal to simply p by root 2. Dx and this value is equal to dx by root 2. And what about the limits? The corresponding limit, p limit k square is equal to p square by 2 and p is equal to root 2k and don't bother about the infinity. If we place infinity x, then k will be infinity only. Now this can be represented as 2 by root pi and this dx is equal to dp divided by and this dx is equal to dp by root 2. I am placing here equal to 1 by root 2 and integration the corresponding limits are root 2k to infinity then e to the power minus p square by 2 dp. This is the corresponding expression you have 2 by root 2 pi 1 by root 2, this one. This can be modified as 2 by square root of 2 pi integration root 2 k to infinity e to the power minus p square by 2 dp are representing as the minus x square by 2 dx. What is the expression for this one? This is equal to simply have the format q of k only. Q of k equal to 1 by root 2 pi k to infinity e to the power minus x square by 2 dx. So this can be represented as q of root k. This is equal to q of root 2 k. This is the relation between complementary error function and the q function. Very very important this one. Everything will appear again in the PA discussion of the PSK, ASK, FSK. Probability error calculations of the PSK, FSK, KSK and the situation. In generally, the probability error is given by q of root ED by 2 eta. What is that eta? PSK, everything you will see. Q of ED by root eta or root ED by 2 eta. At that situation, everything, they may give you options in the complement error function and they may give you options in the q function. From this we can conclude this q of k is equal to simply 1 by 2 complementary error function of q of k. Simply dividing this k, replace this root 2 k, replace this k with the k by root 2. Okay, replace this k with the k by root 2, this will become q of k, which is equal to 1 by 2 complement error function of k by root 2. This is available in your books. Q of k equal to 1 by 2 complement error function of k by root 2. Okay, this is the final representation of this q of k and complementary error function. Now, write down the question. Okay, wait. One more topic we have to discuss. Wait. Consider the x as a Gaussian random variable. Then what is the probability that x greater than x? They are giving that x is a Gaussian random variable. The corresponding PDF fx of x is equal to 1 by root 2 pi sigma square e to the power minus of x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square. They are asking what is the probability that x greater than x. That is nothing but simply the corresponding probability for x greater than x is equal to 1 by root 2 pi sigma square. Integration x to infinity e to the power minus of x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square dx. whole square divided by 2 sigma square dx. Now I am placing this x minus mu divided by sigma is equal to some variable p, some variable p. From this the corresponding dx, dx by sigma is equal to dp, and the dx is equal to sigma dp, and the dx is equal to sigma dp. And what are the corresponding limits? Corresponding limits here for the x the limit is equal to x, for the p the corresponding limit will become x minus mu by sigma, x minus mu by sigma. So the given integration we reduces to square root of 2 pi sigma square converted to 2 pi sigma square. Limits are from x minus mu by sigma. Limits are from x minus mu by sigma to infinity. Don't bother about the upper limit because upper limit is infinity. Even if you place infinity minus mu by sigma is equal to infinity only. Infinity only. This is equal to e to the power minus p square divided by 2. E to the power minus p square divided by 2 by dp into dp into sigma. I am taking our sigma as here. From this we can write this value is equal to 1 by root 2 pi integration x minus mu by sigma to infinity e to the power minus p square by 2 dp. I am writing this as the again minus x square by 2 dx, minus x square by 2 dx. So this can be represented. This is the expression of your q of k only. In place of k you are having x minus mu by sigma. So this can be called as q of x minus mu by sigma. Q of x minus mu by sigma. So if they ask you what is the probability for p of x greater than x, directly you can write this value is equal to q of x minus mu by sigma in the form of q function. Suppose in the question they may give the values of q of k, that like q of 0.5, like q of 1, like whom? In q of 1.5, q of 2, those will be available in the question. In the question they have given the values of the complementary error function. At that situation, you have to represent this value is equal to this value. What is q of k? Q of k, what is a complementary error function? Which is equal to 1 by 2. What is q of k equal to 1 by 2 complementary error function of k by root 2. So this can be represented as 1 by 2 complementary error function of x minus mu divided by sigma root 2, x minus period by sigma root 2. If they are option in the questions, if they are given the values of error function only, then the error function is equal to simply 1 minus complementary error function of the k. We can write this is equal to 1 by 2 into, this is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 minus error function of x minus period by sigma root 2. Okay, we have to be careful about all these terms. Okay, depending on the question, whatever the values they have given in the question, we have to be consider whether in the q or whether in the error function. In some cases, in the question itself, they will mention the distribution function parameter. That is nothing but as x is a Gaussian random variable. By considering the f as the corresponding PDF, corresponding distribution function, and they will give you the values of f of 0.2. Instead of giving the q values, they will give you the values of f. At that situation, how can you do? For that, you need to know what is the distribution function of this Gaussian random variable. That will be given by simply the distribution function is equal to integration of the PDF only, integration of the density function only. So I am treating the probability distribution function as the f. I am treating the corresponding is equal to simply fx of x. X is a random variable and x is the random variable. The corresponding probability distribution function fx of x is equal to simply your integration minus infinity to x fx of dx, minus infinity to x fx of dx. This can be represented as 1 by square root of 2 pi sigma square integration minus infinity to x e to the power minus of x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square dx. X minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square dx. I am placing this x minus mu divided by sigma equal to p and try to conclude what is the expression for the probability of x greater than x. Now simply by placing x minus mu by sigma is equal to k, x minus mu divided by sigma is equal to p. As like previous case only, x minus mu divided by sigma is equal to p. From this dx equal to sigma dp. From this c equal to sigma dp, and you will get this equal to 1 by root 2 pi integration minus infinity to limit changes to x minus mu by sigma e to the power minus x square by 2 dx, minus x square by 2 dx. What is the value of this one? 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity to x minus mu by sigma e to the power minus x square by 2. This value is equal to simply 1 by root 2 pi, no, sorry, simply q of minus k is equal to minus of x minus mu by sigma. Q of minus k only the given expression is. Okay, minus infinity to k. The corresponding is the minus k only q of minus of x minus mu by sigma. So this can be represented as fx of x is equal to okay, now write this one. This is equal to 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma. 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma. So this can be represented as 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma. Or you can call this equal to fx of x minus mu by sigma is equal to q of 1 minus q of x. 1 minus q of x. So you can write in the form of, you can convert the given variable q of function into the f, or the given f into the given f into the given f into the q function or q into the f function. So finally you can conclude 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma is equal to, finally you can conclude 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma is equal to fx of x minus mu by sigma. Here is value x minus mu by sigma is equal to p. X minus mu by sigma is equal to p, and it changes to 1 by root 2 pi x, it changes to x minus mu by sigma. X changes to x minus mu by sigma. So here also you have to place the corresponding x changes to x minus mu by sigma. Here the corresponding x is represented to this one. Here the corresponding x changes to x minus mu by sigma. Here also x changes to x minus mu by sigma. And finally you can conclude 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma is equal to fx of x minus mu by sigma. Depending on the question you need to consider. If you conclude about this one, the probability p of x less than or equal to x is equal to p of x less than or equal to x is equal to, in earlier we got for x greater than x is equal to q of x minus mu by sigma. X less than or equal to x is nothing but 1 minus p of x greater than x only. 1 minus p of x greater than x only. 1 minus p of x greater than x. This value is equal to 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma. 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma. X minus mu by sigma. Or we can call this value is equal to simply your fx of x minus mu by sigma. Fx of x minus mu by sigma. You can call this as simply fx of x minus mu by sigma. Since 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma is equal to fx of x minus mu by sigma only. Where f is in the form of distribution function. Depending on the values they have given in the question, you have to consider. Okay, if q values is given, directly you can take. F values are given, you have to take. If complement error function values are given, you have to consider this one. Suppose what is the probability for x1 less than or equal to x2. From the distribution point of view, directly you can write this value equal to fx of x2. This value is equal to fx of x2 minus fx of x1. Fx of x2 minus fx of x1. Okay, so this can be represented as f of x2 minus mu divided by sigma, x2 minus mu by mu divided by sigma minus x2 minus mu by sigma minus fx of x1 minus mu by sigma minus fx of x minus mu x1 minus mu by sigma. That is only we have seen fx of x. Finally we have concluded the corresponding is equal to fx of x minus mu by sigma. So similar corresponding is equal to q of minus of x minus mu by sigma, which is equal to your fx of x minus mu by sigma. X minus mu by sigma. And from this this value fx of x1 is equal to, we have concluded q of minus of x minus mu by sigma corresponding is equal to fx of x1 minus sigma. Fx of x1 minus mu by sigma, this is the corresponding probability in the range x1 to x2. Corresponding probability in the range from x1 to x2. Now what is that value in terms of q function? This is equal to f of x2 minus mu by sigma minus f of x1 minus mu by sigma. In terms of q function, how can you write this one? This is equal to simply 1 minus q of x2 minus mu by sigma minus of 1 minus q of x1 minus mu by sigma. Simple analysis only, nothing is there. So this is equal to 1 minus q of x2 minus, this can be 1 on 1 get cancelled, and this is equal to q of x1 minus mu by sigma minus q of x2 minus mu by sigma. Q of x1 minus mu by sigma minus q of x2 minus mu by sigma. What is this q of x1 minus mu by sigma? All we have seen, we have the probability for x greater than x1. What is the this q of x1 minus mu by sigma? Is nothing but probability for x greater than x1 minus probability for x greater than x2 this one is 1 minus q of x2 minus mu by sigma. That is equal probability for x greater than x2. What is this one? What is this one? This is equal to some simply for x greater than x1, simply for some random variable, some Gaussian random variable, this is equal to x1 and this is equal to x2. This is equal to x2. So the probability for x greater than x1 means this total region minus the probability for x greater than x2. X greater than x2, this is the region for x1 less than x less than x less than or equal to x2. X1 less than x less than or equal to x2. Getting my point or not? This is equal to probability for x greater than x1. Greater than x1 minus the probability for x greater than minus the probability for x greater than x2, which is equal to the region from x1 less than x less than or equal to x2 only, which is equal to your x1 x1 less than x less than or equal to x2 only, x2 only. And how can you write this one? Fx of x2 minus fx of x1, already we have seen, already we have seen already we have seen in the starting of the cumulative, the time of cumulative distribution function, which is equal to probability for x less than or equal to x2, probability for x less than or equal to x2 minus probability for x less than or equal to x1, which is equal to your x1 to x2, which is equal to your x1 to x2. So in terms of f or in terms of p or in terms of q, okay, for x1 less than x less than or equal to x2, in terms of q this value equal to q of x1 minus mu by sigma minus q of x2 minus sigma, or in terms of f this value is equal to f of x2 minus mu by sigma minus f of x1 minus mu by sigma. Nothing is there, okay, simple, simple. If you try to do on your own, definitely you will get and definitely you will remember these things, these everything forever, okay, definitely remember everything forever. Finally, I'm giving some conclusion here. For x is a random variable, Gaussian random variable. Whose PDF is equal to fx of x is equal to 1 by root 2 pi sigma square is equal to 1 by root 2 pi sigma square e to the power minus of x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square minus of x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square whole square by 2 sigma square. The corresponding probability for x greater than x, I am writing for corresponding probability for x greater than x. Greater than x is equal to simply your q of x minus mu divided by sigma, x minus mu divided by sigma, and which is equal to 1 minus p of x less than or equal to x, 1 minus p of x less than or equal to x. This is equal to 1 minus your fx of x, 1 minus your fx of x. This is equal to 1 minus f of x minus mu divided by sigma, 1 minus f of x minus mu divided by sigma. In terms of f, this is equal to 1 minus f of x minus mu by sigma. In terms of complement error function, this can be represented as 1 by 2 complement error function of x minus mu by root 2 sigma. X minus mu by sigma root 2 or x minus mu by root 2 sigma, and the relation between this f and this all we have derived, which is equal to f of x minus mu by sigma is equal to 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma, 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma. For the particular region, then suppose x1 less than x less than or equal to x2, the corresponding is equal to fx of x2 minus fx of x1, fx of x2 minus fx of x1. This can be represented as f of x2 minus mu by sigma, x2 minus mu by sigma minus f of x1 minus mu by sigma, if the question is having the values of f, if the question is having the values of f function, or this can be represented as q of x1 minus mu by sigma minus q of x2 minus mu by sigma, if there are in the form of q function, and this can be represented in the form of this one directly. You can write this is equal to complementary error function of x1 minus mu divided by root 2 sigma minus 1 by 2 complementary error function of x2 minus mu by root 2 sigma, x2 minus mu by root 2 sigma. Depending on the given question, you can take any value of the probability of the Gaussian random variable, any probability of this Gaussian random variable, the particular range, or in this one, or like this one. S greater than x equal to q of x minus mu by sigma. And all these points we have to remember. This is a simple, just to do 2 to 3 times of this analyzation. Okay, how the q function was evolved, how the complement error function was evolved, how this f function was evolved. Okay, all these values they mention in the table. They mention in the table clearly, like your communication system. What was that? What was it? FM. JN of beta. Other situation they clearly mention you the JN of JN of 1 equal to this much, JN of 2.5 equal to this much, J2 of 1 equal to this much, the value they will give you and they will ask you the corresponding requirement. They will ask you the requirements. Here also everything they will mention here, Q function or complement error function or in the form of this F function. From that you need to calculate the corresponding, you need to calculate the required probability. Required probability. Now write up, what are the values of Q of K plus Q of minus K is equal to how much? Q of K plus Q of minus K is equal to how much? Q of K plus Q of minus K is equal to simple integration substitution. Integration substitution. Nothing is there here. Gaussian random variable. Okay. What is the value of Q of K plus Q of minus K equal to how much? Error function of K plus error function of minus K equal to how much? Complementary error function of K plus complementary error function of minus K equal to how much? Error function of K plus complementary error function of K equal to how much? Error function of K plus complementary error function of K equal to how much? All these values you have to write down. Already we know Q of K plus Q of minus K is equal to 1, no need to do this one. Q of K plus Q of minus K is equal to 1 only. And what about this one? Error function of K plus complementary error function of K is equal to 1 already we know. 1 already we know. You need to calculate this one. Now I am considering this question. Complementary error function of K plus error, sorry, complementary error function of minus K. As we know, the complementary Q of K is equal to 1 by 2. Complementary error function of K. Complementary error function of K by root 2. 1 by 2 complementary error function of K by root 2. From this is equal to 2 into Q of K is equal to 2 into Q of K is equal to complementary error function of K by root 2. And I am writing this equal to 2 into Q of K root 2. Multiplying this with the this K by root 2 with the replacing this K with the K root 2. Replacing this K with the K root 2. This value is equal to complementary error function of K. Complementary error function of K. What about this complementary error function of minus K? Complementary error function of minus k is equal to simply 2 into q of minus k root 2. 2 into q of minus k root 2. By addition of these two, by adding these two, our required value is equal to 2 into q of k root 2, k of k root 2 plus q of minus k root 2. What is this value? Q of k root 2 is nothing but integration k root 2 to infinity. And q of minus k root 2 is nothing but integration. This is equal to k root to infinity and this is equal to integration minus infinity to k root 2. Minus infinity to k root 2. By combining these values, you will get which is equal to integration minus infinity to infinity which is equal to 1 only. That nothing but 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity infinity e to the power minus h square by 2 dx value which is, whose value is equal to 1 only. So the corresponding is equal to 2 into 1 which is equal to 1. So the complement error function of k plus complement error function of minus k is equal to 2. Value is 2. Value is 2. Don't confuse and don't write 1 blindly. Okay, and another one is the error function of k plus complement error function of minus k is equal to how much? Error function of k plus complement error function of minus k is equal to how much? We need to calculate. We need to calculate. What is this error function of k actually? What is this error function of k? Error function of k is equal to 2 by root pi integration 0 to k e to the power minus x square dx. This is only okay. 2 by root pi integration 0 to pi e to the power minus x square dx. What is this error function of minus k? Is equal to simply 2 by root pi integration 0 to minus k e to the power minus x square dx e to the power minus x square dx. This one only, right? Clear? In case of k, you will get minus k. That's it. 0 to minus k e to the power minus x square dx. I am placing this x square as the p. This x square as the p square. Then what about this value? Try to do one calculate about this error function of k plus error function of minus k. Try to do simple modification, simple manipulation. If you are not getting with x square equal to p square, try with another one, anything. X square equal to p square or x equal to p. Our intention is that we need to convert this into like this form. Like this form. That nothing but k to be changes to minus k. K to be changed to minus k. How can you change? simply by placing x equal to minus p. By placing x equal to minus p, you have dx is equal to minus dp, and this can be represented as minus 2 by root pi integration 0 to k e to the power minus p square dp over minus p square dp, which is equal to minus 2 by root pi integration 0 to k e to the power minus x square dx. By adding this 1 and 2, I considering this as the 1 and this as the 2. By adding this 1 and 2, you get error function of k minus plus error function of minus k is equal to 0. Okay. In the similar way, try to conclude this one. Earlier case, complement error function of k plus complement error function of minus k is equal to 2. We have concluded using the q function. In the similar way, in this fashion, by using this expression and the substitution, try to conclude this one. We will see. We will observe the difference and we will see. Okay, simple integration is only nothing. It's equal to er of c of k is equal to er of c of k is equal to 2 by root pi integration k to infinity e to the power minus x square dx. What about this complement error function of minus k? Er of c of minus k you have to do. Okay, 2 by root pi integration minus k to infinity e to the power minus x square dx. Then, how can you conclude about this one? In this way, try to do. As like in this way, we substitute x equal to minus p here. dx is equal to minus dp, and the corresponding limits are changed to this is equal to 2 by root pi integration k to minus infinity e to the power minus p square dp with the negative, minus p square dp with negative. So this can be represented as 2 by root pi integration minus infinity to k e to the power minus x square dx. This can be represented as like this, minus infinity to k e to the power minus x square dx. In earlier case, because of this zero, even after substitution, we are having the zero only. Okay, and minus k became k, so 0 to k. Here, this is because of this infinity will become minus infinity, and this minus k will become k, and after doing the interchange of this limit, this will become minus infinity to k e to the power minus x square dx only. Take this as the 1 and this as the 2. By adding this 1 and 2, you have this is only the difference. Okay, this is only the, because why you are having the minus here is because here there is no need to interchange these limits, because the lower limit is equal to 0 only. Here the two of the limits are going to be changes. Here minus k will become k and minus infinity may become minus infinity. By adding those two. By adding those two, we have error function of k plus complement error function of minus k is equal to what you get? 2 into 1 by root pi integration k to infinity. I am writing first that one. Integration minus infinity to k e to the power minus x square dx plus 1 by root pi integration k to infinity e to the power minus x square dx. By converting this in the form of the q function, you have there should be the term x square by 2 by replacing x square by 2 is equal to p square by 2, and doing some analysis, you will compute this equal to 2 into 1 by root 2 pi integration minus infinity to root 2k e to the power minus x square by 2 dx plus 1 by root 2 pi integration root 2k to infinity e to the power minus x square by 2 dx, like as in the previous case only. This is equal to q of minus root 2k plus upon combining these two, you will get 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity to infinity e to the power minus x square by 2 dx, whose value is equal to 1, this value is equal to 2. In this way, you can calculate what is this complement error function of k plus complement error function of minus k. No need to calculate all this, we can remember also. Okay, complement error function of k plus complement error function of minus k is equal to 2. Okay, in the end of the examination, you are familiar with the q of k plus q of minus k is equal to 1. You may put this value is equal to 1. Okay, this value to be equal to 2. For analyzation, you have to do this type of analyzation. Okay, whatever analyzation we have done, try to do 2 to 3 times. Then because then if you do the analyzation, you may not forget all these expressions. What is for q of x, what is for error function of x, what is for f function of x, and what is the probability for particular region. Particular region with respect to this Gaussian random variable. If you try to by heart all these formulas, you may forget. If you do 2 to 3 times and 2 to 3 times of this analyzation, you may not forget. It will take around 1 hour per day. It will be, you have to remember forever. Okay, if you consider this 1 hour is waste for you for doing all the generalization, you may forget in within 1 month or within 2 months. Okay, this type only. Now, write down a question. A Gaussian random variable x. Is varying with mean is equal to 2. And variance is equal to 4. Then find fx of 1. In terms of q function. Fx of 1 nothing but simply p of x less than or equal to 1, which is equal to 1 minus p of x greater than 1, which is equal to, already we know, equal to q of x minus mu by sigma. So this value is equal to 1 minus q of x is equal to what you are having, 1. 1 minus mu divided by what is the sigma variance they have given, that is sigma square equal to 4. From this sigma is equal to 2, already we have seen. Sigma is equal to 2, so this value is equal to 2. This is equal to 1 minus q of minus 1 by 2. This is equal to q of 1 by 2. This is equal to q of 1 by 2. If they ask you in the form of f function, then simply this is equal to f of x minus mu by sigma. F of x minus mu by sigma, that is nothing but f of minus 1 by 2. This is equal to simply f of x minus mu by sigma. This is equal to f of 1 minus 2 by 2. This value is equal to f of minus 1 by 2. Since we have f of x minus mu by sigma equal to 1 minus q of minus of x minus mu by sigma, already we have seen. Depending on the question, you need to write. If you want to represent in the complement error function, directly you can write. This is equal to 1 by 2 complement error function of k by root 2, that is nothing but 1 by 2 root 2. 1 by 2 complement error function of 1 by 2 root 2. Okay, all these simple questions and simple points. They may expect, you may expect all these in examination. Okay, they are giving also. They are giving all these type of questions only they are asking, and they are asking in the examination. Now, right, one more question I wrote clearly. A Gaussian random variable x. For which mean is equal to 0. And variance is equal to and the standard deviation directly they have given. Standard deviation is equal to 4.2 volts. Mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation is equal to 4.2 volts. Appears across a 100 ohms resistor. With a power rating of 0.25 watts. Full stop. The probability that the voltage will cause, given is the Gaussian random voltage x. Gaussian random variable x is the Gaussian random voltage x. Find the probability that the voltage will cause an instantaneous power. That exceeds the resistance rating. Instantaneous power that exceeds the resistance rating. they are saying that the voltage of these are Gaussian random variable with mean is equal to 0 and sigma standard deviation equal to 4.2 volts appears across the 100 ohms resistor then and the power rating they have given as 100 ohms resistor which a power rating is equal to 0.25 watt 100 ohms resistor with power rating is equal to 0.25 that nothing but if the power rating is equal to 0.25 watt nothing but the resistance can sustain up to the dissipation capacity equal to 0.25 watt the power rating of this one okay the power rating is equal to 0.25 watt that is the information they have given what is the probability that the voltage of the variable x will cause an instantaneous power that exceeds the resistance rating what is the probability that the resistance may damage okay resistance may damage nothing but what is the probability that the power may exceeds the rating of the resistance that is nothing but the power is they have given this will be greater than 5 watts this will be greater than 0.25 and this what is this p value p is equal to simply x square divided by r since x is equal to your voltage so x square divided by r should be greater than 0.25 and x square should be greater than r is equal to how much r is equal to 100 ohms resistance equal to 100 into 0.25 that nothing but x square is greater than 5 x square is greater than 5 is nothing but we can conclude from this the mod x is greater than 5 don't supposed to consider only x all we have discussed in the introduction whenever we are having x square term we have to be consider the positive and negative values also so this is always equal to mod x greater than 1 whenever the instant the voltage mod x greater than 1 case is appear the resistor may damage that is nothing but the power rating of the resistor may process the given power rating which is equal to 0.25 how can you calculate the probability of this one so you are asked to calculate the probability for which the voltage is greater than 5 this is the condition you need to calculate this is equal to what is this one already we have seen mod x greater than 5 is nothing but x greater than 5 and x less than minus 5 x greater than 5 and x less than minus is equal to 5 and this is your minus 5 mod x greater than 5 nothing but this is the region yesterday we have seen in last session we have seen 1% okay greater than 5 nothing but x greater than 5 and x less than 5 what is the probability x greater than 5 comma x greater than 5 comma x less than minus 5 what is the probability for x greater than 5 and what is the probability for x less than minus 5 try to write in the formulas in the form of q function options are there in the form of q function x greater than 5 is nothing but simply you can write corresponding equal to directly q of x minus mu by sigma and what about this x less than minus 5 for this directly you can write q of x minus mu by sigma what about that one which is equal to 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma so this can be represented as for this one is equal to q of x minus mu by sigma plus 1 minus q of x minus mu by sigma so from this we can conclude this value x is equal to how much value 5 x is equal to 5 minus mu equal to 0 divided by standard deviation is equal to 4.2 plus 1 minus q of minus 5 minus 0 divided by 4.2 minus 5 minus 0 by 4.2 and this can be represented as q of 5 by 4.2 plus 1 minus q of minus 5 by 4.2 this value is equal to simply q of 5 by 4.2 and what about this value this is equal to q of 5 by 4.2 only q of k plus q of minus k is equal to 1 1 minus q of minus k is equal to q of k only so this value is equal to 2 into q of 5 divided by 4.2 2 into q of 5 by 4.2 these type options are available like q of 5 by 4.2 q of 2 into q by 5 by 4.2 and q of 5 by 4.2 like this they will in the form of q function they will give you now and the next one write down a question if x is a Gaussian random variable if
x is a Gaussian random variable with mean equal to 2, with mean equal to 2, variance equal to 4, with mean equal to 2, variance equal to 4, with mean equal to 2, variance equal to 4, at all values of random variable x, at all values of random variable x, at all values of the random variable x separated from its mean by 4, separated its mean by 4, then its density is, then its density is, madam, clearly have given, x is a random variable with mean is equal to 2, with mean is equal to 2, and variance is equal to 4, and variance is equal to 4. At all values of random variable, x separated from its mean, separated from its mean by 4. For all values of random variable, separated from its mean by 4, then what is the corresponding density? Then what is its corresponding density? This is only they are asking. Okay. This is only they are asking. For that, please listen this one. Listen this concept. If for the random variable x, separated from its mean by sigma, random variable x having some value mu, separated from its by what is the value here? Equal to simply 1 by root 2 pi sigma square only. Simply square root of 1 by root 2 pi sigma square only. If for all values of x separated from its mean by sigma, then the corresponding value here is equal to 0.606 divided by square root of 2 pi sigma square. And if there are separated by 2 sigma, corresponding value equal to 0.135 divided by this one. Denominator is this one only, square root of 2 pi sigma square. And if it is separated by 3 sigma for all values of x, then the corresponding density here is equal to 0.01 divided by square root of 2 pi sigma square. This is the Gaussian random variable function. And x is the random variable of the Gaussian random variable. Now, for our question, given mu is equal to 2 and the variance is equal to 4, for all values of the x separated by 2 from its mean. That is nothing but separated by 2 from its mean. Or 4 from its mean. What is it again? Or separated from its mean by 4. Then what is the corresponding density they are asking? Okay, here sigma square equal to 4 they have given. From this sigma is equal to 2 and 2 sigma is equal to 4. 2 sigma equal to 4 indirectly. Now all values of x, those are separated from its mean by 2 sigma. The corresponding value of this density is equal to 0.135 upon square root of 2 pi sigma square. So the corresponding value equal to 0.135 divided by square root of 2 pi into sigma square equal to 4 they have given. This value equal to 0.135 divided by 2 into root 2 pi, whatever the value you will get, that will be, okay. If there are separated by 2, that is nothing but separated by sigma, the corresponding is equal to 0.606 by root 2 pi sigma square. If they are separated by 6, is nothing but the corresponding value is equal to 1 by root 2 pi sigma, 0.01 by root 2 pi sigma square, this also you have to be remember, take it down as it is, okay, the meaning is that if all the values of x separated from its mean, separated
from its mean probability that all the values of x separated from its mean by sigma, this one, by sigma, by 2 sigma, this one, and by 3 sigma, this one, for this, at that value, the corresponding density is equal to 0.606 root square root of 2 by sigma square. At the value of mu, the corresponding density is equal to simply, as we have mu is equal to, density is equal to square root of 2 by sigma square, e to the power minus of x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square, by 2 sigma square, at the mean, if x equal to mu, the corresponding value equal to 1 by root 2 by sigma square. If the values of x separated from its mean by sigma, then the corresponding value equal to this one, 0.606 by root 2 by sigma square. From its mean by 2 sigma, at that equation, this is the value and this is the value. Substituting all these values here also, you will get this magnitude. This magnitude up to this one, up to sigma 2 sigma.